just had an idea.
It didn't hurt, did it?
Cut it out. Are you interested or aren't you? Yeah, I've just had a thought where we could lay our hands on a bit of dough.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Jeez, she must be a really big one, eh? Mm. I mean, to get on telly.
Yeah.
I never got on telly.
Oh, strike a light. They put every flaming petty thief on the news. It'd run 24 hours a day.
That's what I mean. I mean, she must be in for something really big.
Yeah, well, it stands to reason, doesn't it?
I wonder if they'll let me out for uni tomorrow.
Oh, I don't think so. They seem pretty keen on us not finding out who the new prisoner is.
So they probably won't. Oh, damn it! How am I supposed to pass if I'm not allowed to go to my lectures? It's bad enough not having access to a reasonable library.
Yeah, I know just how you feel.
Anyway, they're wasting their time. I reckon I figured out who it is anyway.
Who is it then?
Well, I don't know her bloody name, do I? But it stands to reason. The last two times they tried to stop us from finding out who a new prisoner was when Barbie Davidson and Ann Yates came in. Right. And they were both peddling drugs.
Yeah, maybe it's Barbie Davidson.
Oh, geez, Lizzie.
What?
Oh, all I'm saying is that it stands to reason the new prisoner must be a pusher. Oh. And if she is a pusher, they can keep her in solitary as long as they like. I'll take care of her when she gets out. Very good care.
Come on, Doctor. Oh. Now, you should be very fit. Stairs should not present a problem.
It's been a long day.
It's no excuse.
Well, blame the dinner then.
Oh, don't you like my restaurant?
Oh, it's delicious.
Come on. How am I supposed to get the key in the door?
Never mind the door.
What if the jeans still out?
I don't give a stuff about...
It's 2 a.m.
We've been burgled.
No.
Police have been. As far as I can see, all that's missing is $20 and a transistor radio.
Well, nothing else?
Well, it certainly wasn't professionals. The police think it was kids. Anyway, I've spent the last 2 hours cleaning the place up.
Oh, sorry. Look, I would have come home earlier. I thought that you and Greg might want to be alone.
Oh, I hope you haven't been walking around the parks.
No, I spent my time very pleasantly.
And not a hair out of place.
Well, let's finish this. What about these?
Oh, I'm throwing them out. Nothing like having everything dumped on the floor to have a good clean-up.
Well, must have been a bit of a shock coming home to it.
Yes, it was.
I'm surprised that Greg didn't stay.
Oh, he wanted to, but I sent him home. He's got an early morning, signing the documents to the practice.
Yeah, even so.
I can manage on my own.
Sure.
Cocoa?
Love some.
It's the new woman in the pound, that's what it is.
She's off a bloody rocket.
Oh, no, she's not. Listen.
What?
Nice and steady. Pacing herself. If she just yelled and screamed, her voice wouldn't last 20 minutes. She could go on for hours.
Oh, no.
Use your head, it's pressure on the screws.
Wish they'd build her one, not now.
Not in here, they won't.
You think that means she's been inside before?
It just means she's got a few brains, that's all. Well, we're not helping her lying here, are we?
Oh, what are you on about?
She's a fellow prisoner, isn't she? Going off her nut in the pound.
Oh, you're just out for a stir.
Keeps the screws on their toes. Besides, I wouldn't mind having a look at that one myself. Let her out! Let her out!
Oh, my God.
Let her out! Let her out! Let her out!
Oh, shut up!
Shut them up. How can I do that? I don't run this prison. Let her out.
Smith!
Mm? I'm just helping out a fellow prisoner, one that's being victimized, Vera. Let her out!
Out!
You shut them up, Smith, or so God help.
You're going to victimize me, are you, Vera?
Well, you all stay locked in your cells until this stops.
Oh, let her out! Let her out! Let her out!
Hey, what do you know? It's time to wake up.
Let her out! Let her out!
Mrs. Davidson?
How long has this been going on?
Nearly an hour.
How did it start?
Bella Albrecht in solitary, and then Smith got into the act.
I might have known.
What do you propose to do?
I'm not sure.
You're not going to negotiate with Smith. Give her an inch and she'll try and take over completely.
Smith and I understand each other very well. She knows just how far she can go.
They don't give a damn about that woman in solitary.
I'm well aware of that.
Well, listen to them. They're animals.
That's enough, Miss Bennett. Let's have it out with Smith. What's the meaning of this?
Well, it's that poor woman in solitary, isn't it? Of course, if you were letting
her... Well, if that's all you're worried about, you can stop this nonsense immediately. She was due to come out this morning.
Well, of course she was.
It's true.
Well, there's no problem then, is there?
Shut up!
Well, what do you know about that?
What now? Normal procedure, let them all out. And I want to see Travers before she goes out this morning.
Nice of you to change your mind, Vera.
You realize why you're being told all this, Karen?
I think so.
Bella Albrecht's case has caused a great deal of sensational publicity. You're bound to hear about it. But there's no reason why the others should know. I'm putting a great deal of trust in you. If some of them do hear about it, there could be very serious repercussions.
They won't find out from me.
You may come under some serious pressure.
I can cope.
Yes, I'm sure you can. That's why I'm letting you continue with your studies. But if there should be a leak, you will forfeit your study release and your parole will be suspended.
That wasn't necessary, Mrs. Davidson.
Perhaps not. But under the circumstances, I think it was better. You may go.
What she's going to turn out to be.
You mark my words.
Now, what would they do putting a spy in here?
Well, they got to put them somewhere. I mean, they're people like anybody else.
I reckon Lizzie's right.
What would you know? You're so thick you wouldn't know they hit you with a pickaxe.
Well, if she's not a spy, why have they put her in the pound?
Look, if she was a spy, they'd have her up in Canberra, filling her full of champers, asking her what she knew. Now, I reckon she's got to be a pusher.
I reckon you're both wrong. I reckon she's a heavy from another jail. And the screws are leaving her locked up until she's good and mad before they let her loose.
You haven't done a stitch of work all day.
Smoko.
Smoko's over as of now.
You reckon?
Yeah.
Oh, she's coming. She's coming. She's coming.
Get moving.
What do you reckon, V?
We'll see. She's no heavy, that's for sure.
She's certainly not a bloody spy.
How do you know?
Will you shut up, the lot of you?
They look all right to me.
Looks can be deceptive.
Oh, I managed all right this morning.
Think so?
Well, it got me out of solitary, didn't it?
Just keep quiet and get moving.
Stand there. You had no right to keep me in solitary for so long.
Keep quiet.
I know my rights.
After that performance earlier this morning, I have every right to put you straight back into solitary.
And I'd do the same as I did this morning.
I can assure you, it wouldn't have the same effect. And the more you misbehaved, the longer you would stay there. which would save us all a great deal of trouble.
I'm not the only person in here who's killed someone.
You are the only person who has killed a child. And in the eyes of these women, there is no worse crime, particularly your own child.
That hasn't been proved yet.
Oh, I assure you the legalities won't worry these women. However, we can't keep you in solitary indefinitely. The longer we do, the more curious they will become. I am assigning you to the garden where you will work on your own. You will mix with the other women at recreation times.
Well, if it keeps me out of solitary, I don't mind.
We have gone to a great deal of trouble to ensure your safety. We have actually denied television, radio, and newspapers to all the prisoners. I do not intend to have those efforts wasted. You will invent a story about your crime, and you will make it a good one.
I'm surprised you're so concerned about me.
It's not that I am so concerned. I just don't want you murdered in my prison. You will be in a single cell. Behave yourself and be careful.
No problems. Well, she's got a lot to learn.
Yes, perhaps. Maybe I should have kept her in solitary regardless.
Oh, I don't think you had any choice.
It'll mean stricter supervision, more load on the staff.
What else can we do? Her trial can't come quick enough for me.
I couldn't agree more.
Well, get yourself organised. I'll come back and take you to the garden.
Could take quite a while to rearrange the furniture.
I'll give you a word of advice. If you want to get by in here, say the smart remarks.
I saw you in the corridor, didn't I? I'm Bella Albrecht.
I'm Lizzie. Lizzie Birdsworth. And this here's B.
I run this place, just in case the screws forgot to tell you.
Oh, you must have had something to do with this morning.
Could have.
I'm grateful. I think that's why they let me out.
How come they locked you in for so long?
Standing up for my rights, I suppose.
Are you a spy?
What? No.
Oh.
Don't suppose you've got any connections. Some of the girls, well, we could do with a new source of supply.
I'm sorry, and I don't approve of drugs.
Oh, pity.
What are you in for?
I killed my husband.
Go on. So did I. flaying up, was he?
That's right.
How'd you do it? I shot mine.
Carving knife.
Oh. What, in the bedroom or the kitchen?
Kitchen.
It's amazing the crimes of passion that happen in the kitchen. Not to mention the other things that happen in the kitchen.
I know what you mean.
I remember one anniversary. Oh, my old man and I were a bit bored. And he had some champers in the fridge. Anyway, he went to open the fridge door. When he did, I turned the light off and said, let's forget the champers, just leave the fridge door open. And he did. Bread knife, you say?
Carving knife.
Oh, yeah, that's right. How come they locked you up for so long? Bit emotional, were you?
Well, I wasn't, as a matter of fact. Perhaps that's why.
Yeah, maybe that is it. Can't imagine you getting emotional. Not after this morning. How come they've locked you in again, though?
Oh, you know. I mean, who knows why they do anything?
Me? Yeah. Lizzie, what are you doing here?
Oh, just having a bit of a talk, Mrs. Jackson.
You're supposed to be in the laundry.
We were just talking.
First thing you better learn, Bella, is to speak when you're spoken to. Now, come along, you two.
Ooh, personal escort. We'll see you later, Bella. Talk some more.
Sorry, you're not a spy.
Get moving. And if you know what's good for you, you'll keep right away from those two.
Ruth, you win again.
Piss off! I hate anyone watching me losing. Oh, come on, Martha, come on, just one more time, eh? Go on, you're on a winning streak.
Yeah, that's the lot.
Piss off, you're poison!
Oh, you wouldn't read about it.
I win. Yeah, reckon you must have changed me luck.
What about me?
Oh, don't be like that, Martha. Here you go. And one for the pot. How are you getting on with B?
All right.
Hmm.
You know, I reckon if it weren't for Bea, you could be running this joint. Nothing against Bea, mind you. Still, I reckon she's your main problem. Still, it's not for me to say. Right. And you got to be careful what you say around here anyway. Bea has a way of finding things out. And I wouldn't want her saying I was making trouble.
Well, well, what do you know? Working. Must have heard us coming.
Stay here, you two. Bourke, you've got a visitor.
Have a look at her. If there was Olympic Games stop and work, they'd give you a gold medal.
You're not doing too badly yourself this morning.
I'm not in the event, Mrs. Jackson. What are you staring at, dummy?
Hi, Mum.
How come they let you in again?
Got special permission. Said I had some important personal news.
You're not up the duff, are you?
Oh, no, Mum.
What's up then?
Nothing's up. Just wanted to see you.
Oh, don't give me that.
I met this guy. He's real nice.
Real nice, eh?
He's renting a flat. Said I'd move in with him. Save on rent.
What rent? You're living at home. You're not paying any rent.
I'm moving out. I'm 16, Mum. There's no privacy and I'm sick of it.
What about the family?
They don't need me at home. Money coming in, that's what they need. Denny's promised to help.
Denny?
Yeah, that's his name. Oh, he's real nice.
How old is he?
About 20. Oh, he's so smart.
He's got a job?
What, working?
It's a bad move.
I'm 16, Mum.
Oh, yeah. Fat lot, you know. You're the reason I'm back inside. That's how smart you are. Go to a doctor. Get yourself on the pill.
I'm already on it. Oh, Mum, stop worrying. I can take care of myself. Denny and me, we already pulled a job.
What job? What'd you get?
What we wanted? $20 and a tranny.
$20 and a tranny?
Yeah, that's what we wanted.
Hi.
Hi, what's wrong?
I am about to do my block. Know what's just happened? You know Leanne Bourke, you know, Noeline's daughter? Well, she came to visit her mother. Well, she was here yesterday, so I had to cut through a lot of red tape to get a visit approved because she said it was important. Well, there I was, standing there, when I suddenly overheard Leanne telling her mother about a burglary.
Oh, no, I'm trying to break that cycle.
Oh, hang on a second. Know what she told her mother was stolen?
No.
$20 and a transistor radio.
What?
That was my flat that kid broke into, our flat. Sitting there, as bold as brass, telling her mother all about it all. It was quite bizarre.
Did you say anything?
What could I say? They'd deny it till the cars came home. But I'm going to tell the police.
Yeah, of course.
Well, what's wrong?
Well, I spoke to Leanne yesterday.
Oh, Jean, you couldn't have. You wouldn't have.
Look, I know it was stupid. But I'm trying to break them out of this terrible cycle they're in, where one Bourke follows the other down the same garden path. I'm sorry. I'll replace the transistor and the money.
Oh, you don't have to. That'll clinch it for the police.
Oh, don't go and tell the police. Don't go and tell them. She's just a kid, and with her sort of background, it could... Well, it could break her. Look, I'm sorry. It's all my fault. I'm a fool.
All right, then. Let's forget it. But the next time you conduct a social experiment, just leave me out of it, okay?
Sure, sure. But thanks. Meg, Leanne let me down, but somebody else mightn't have.
You've got a lot to learn. And as for Leanne, she's already past it.
Oh, I'll talk to Noeline. Well, maybe she can knock some sense into the kid's head.
I'll believe that when I see it.
Yeah, well, one day is solitary, that's normal. But let's see. They've taken away our television, our radio disappears, and we're not getting any newspapers.
Maybe her husband's a spy, and that's why she killed him.
Oh, shut up, Lizzie. Maybe it's a coincidence.
Where's Noeline? Seen a visitor and shot through, I suppose.
Reckon I could find out.
Where Noeline is? I know exactly where she is. In the nearest dunny smoking.
This Bella. Bet I could fix it up to find out why she's in.
Could you now? Like you're fixed up to have Monty kidnapped, only they kidnapped Lynn instead. I'm sorry, Martha, but you're too stupid. Besides which, I've got a much better source of information.
Who?
Karen, of course. She's on the outside. She'll see the newspapers. And she'll know what it's all about.
Yeah.
Come in.
Have a seat, Noeline. Relax. Okay, have it your way. It's about your daughter.
What about her?
She is that far away from being in jail. Meg Jackson's flat was burgled last night, and Leanne did it. Meg overheard her telling you about it.
Don't know what you're talking about.
$20 and a tranny.
Never told me nothing about it.
I don't care what you say, she said. We both know what I'm talking about. I'm trying to help the girl.
What do you expect?
Better things than being burgled.
What's it got to do with you anyway? Thought you said it was Mrs. Jackson's place got knocked over.
Yes, well, I recently moved in with Meg and foolishly gave Leanne my address.
Oh, you're right. You're bloody stupid. What do you mean, trying to help her?
I made her apply for the CES.
The doll?
If nothing else, yes.
Why don't you stop sticking your nose in where it doesn't belong? Why don't you mind your own damn
Noeline,
business?
Noeline, it's my job to keep a daughter like you, yours out of jail for the rest of her life. If I hadn't have persuaded Meg Jackson to drop the charge, she'd probably be in jail now.
Oh, big deal.
When next she comes in, would you please have a word with her?
Yeah, I'll have a word with her, all right. I'll tell her the Bourkes have got some pride. No daughter of mine is going on the bloody dole.
Can't you find something else to do?
I thought this was recreation.
If you're waiting for Bella, you can forget it.
Now, what makes you think we're waiting for Bella? We're waiting for someone far more interesting.
Yeah, someone with plenty of information.
Here comes your competition.
Have a good day.
All right.
We met the new girl. Seems really nice.
That's good.
Anything interesting in the newspapers?
I don't have time for all these books.
Looks like you wasn't as clever as you thought.
Get lost, Martha. I want to know about the new girl, Karen. They've stopped all the newspapers, but then you know that, don't you? Got any ideas why?
Get on with your study, Karen.
I see. Gone over to the other side, have we?
B.
Marvellous what early releases will do for people, isn't it? Never mind, there are ways and means of making people talk out there. I'll see you later, Karen.
Now, you try it, Bea, and you'll find yourself in solitary so fast.
Morning.
Good morning.
Hi. Morning. You look as if you've got cause for celebration.
I have. The new practice. I've just been round and signed up.
Oh, congratulations.
Thanks.
Yes, congratulations.
How soon till you start?
2 weeks.
So soon?
Yes, so it's going to be a busy day. I better be going.
You are aware Bella Albrecht is in the prison?
Naturally.
You will also be aware that she has a great security problem. Information about her crime must not be given to any prisoner.
Erica, do you think I'm totally without discretion?
I just wanted to be sure you knew the situation.
Of course. Actually, I'd like to talk to you about her case.
Perhaps later, when things have settled down.
She disturbing your routine?
A little.
It's interesting. Morning.
Morning.
Lovely day.
Dr. Miller.
Good morning, Lizzie. What's wrong?
Nothing. nothing's wrong. I just got a personal problem.
Well, perhaps you should go and see Miss Vernon.
I don't want to see her. I want to see you.
All right. Come on, then. Now.
My heart. It's not the best, is it?
Have you been getting more pains?
No. It's just, well, I could have another attack at any time, couldn't I?
What's the problem, Lizzie?
Oh, I'm worried, Doctor. It's this new doc that's going to replace you. Will he be as good as you are?
Oh, I'm sure he will be.
I don't know. You're one in a million.
Huh. Thank you.
This new one. What sort of doctoring has he done before he comes here?
Well, he hasn't been appointed yet, Lizzie.
What? Oh, but you won't be leaving until he is.
Well, I'm afraid I may have to.
But what about us? What about me? Before you came here, we had to wait 7 months and we had no doctor.
Now, hold on a moment, Lizzie.
Oh, what'll I do if I have one of my turns?
Lizzie, look, I'll be visiting here for several weeks yet. I'm doing everything I can.
I'm sure you are, Doc. I know you won't let us down.
Now, you just keep taking those pills. You'll live for years after you get out of here.
Oh, I don't know. I reckon I'm gonna die in here like poor old Edie.
Edie was different.
No, she wasn't. Nobody wants old people, and that's the truth.
Lizzie, what are you doing in here?
Nothing, Mrs. Jackson.
Yeah, well, that's what I thought. Now, come on, you've got work to do.
You see, just the same as Edie, when you're old and sick, nobody wants you.
What was that all about?
Oh, she's worried because I'm leaving.
Oh, she's a menace. Exploits that weak heart to the hilt. Trouble is, you never know whether she's conning you or not.
Yes, I know. I was feeling really good when I came in here this morning. This place turns everything sour.
It's right what you're doing. It's also right for us. It's going to make things a lot easier.
Yes, well, I'm committed now. Can't push me out of it. Any news on the break-in?
Oh, yes. Solved. Jean.
Jean?
With her social worker flags a-flying, she gave Noeline Burke's daughter our address and said if the girl ever needed help to just drop in.
Oh, you're joking.
And so she did.
I knew you'd regret letting Jean Vernon move back in.
I'll never learn to say no.
Promise.
So people like you come and have a look at the prisons, but the results are always the same. Because the screws are calling the shots.
I assure you, that's not the case with me.
Bulldust.
Well, why do you think I'm talking to you?
Oh, people talk to us all the time, but no one ever does anything. Oh, I don't blame you lot. I don't even blame the screws. It's... Well, I suppose it's...
The system.
Of course it is. You treat people like animals for long enough, it's easy to forget they're not. This lot think we haven't got a brain in our heads. Can I give you an example?
Yeah, please do.
All right. All this business with Bella Albrecht. They take away our television, our newspapers and our radios and then expect us to believe that she's in here for murdering her husband. Well, I didn't get no red carpet. As soon as she came out of solitary, I knew what was up. You think a woman can keep a thing like that to herself for long? Now, there's someone you really ought to be talking to.
Yes, it's a very interesting case.
Yeah, boy, she got problems.
Obviously. The suppression of the maternal instinct to the point where a mother can murder her own child. It's not exactly natural.
Yeah, well, I don't know the big words for it, but she could certainly do with a head shrinker's help. Have you come across her type before?
Yes. The socio-sexual neurotic who feels all her needs will be fulfilled by marriage. Aggravated, no doubt, by the fact that the child was illegitimate in the first place.
Come again?
Well, when another man comes along and she believes that the child is the only reason he won't marry her, the result is logical, if frightening.
Yeah.
And for her to mutilate the body to cast suspicion elsewhere, well, it fits the same destructive logic. It's almost Shakespearean. Mm.
To put it another way, you could say some stupid, callous bitch murdered her own kid so she could marry some dumb bastard of a man.
Yes, I suppose you could.
She'll see. I don't know what to choose. She'll love it. Oh, she'll be around somewhere. There she is.
Smith, Ferguson, get back inside. You too, Eaves.
No problems, Vera. Just taking a break. We thought Bella might be lonely.
You heard me.
Just trying to help, Vera. There's something you should know. You too, Bella. Some of the girls found out she didn't kill her husband. She killed her kid. I don't reckon she'll be too safe in here from now on.
You make one move, Smith.
What, me? I just came to warn poor Bella.
Now get inside.
I reckon that should stir things up.
I reckon.
That bitch, I'll help you fix her.
This takes brains, not muscle. Good, she's so thick she got more layers than a Big Mac.
To yourself.
Why?
Because it's one of the few places that you'll be safe.
Well, why don't you lock the others up? They're the ones making the threats.
Just get a move on.
I want to see the governor.
Oh, you do, do you?
I do not want to be locked in my cell day and night. It's your job to control these hoodlums.
You'll do as you're told or I'll have you back in solitary.
I have a right to see the governor.
Oh, very big on your rights, aren't you? Very well. If you'd rather not be locked in your cell.
Are we going to see the governor?
No.
Where are we going?
We're going to the laundry.
The laundry?
Come on.
You're bluffing. Oh.
You think so?
You can't.
I'm sure B. Smith will let you have all the rights you deserve. Now get in there.
You would have, wouldn't you?
So far, we seem to have got away with it.
By tomorrow, the publicity will have died and we can think about getting back to normal.
Thank heaven for that.
I've had to lock Albrecht in her cell. They know.
What? How could they?
What happened?
I was supervising Albrecht in the garden. Smith arrived and said they knew she'd killed her baby.
Damn. How on earth did they find out?
Oh, I think that's pretty obvious. Karen Travers.
Surely not.
How else?
It's impossible to tell with B.
Well, first things first, what do we do?
There's no alternative. Put her back in solitary.
But her trial's not for a month. We can't keep her in solitary that long.
What else are we supposed to do?
I'm afraid I agree with Meg. It's far too long.
After what she's done?
Well, can't we transfer her to another prison?
No, the other prisons didn't have a news blackout. The women would know.
She'd be in just as much danger.
Then we keep her here, treat her like any other prisoner, and if she gets hurt,
we'll make sure she doesn't get hurt.
It's going to be a lot of strain on the staff guarding her like this, but I suppose there's no other way.
No, I'm afraid there isn't. Albrecht must never be left alone, and she must be kept as far away from B. Smith as possible.
Well, Smith's already beat our security arrangements once already.
Yes, but we do have in Mr. Fletcher a deputy governor who excels in difficult situations. Fill him in with what has happened as soon as possible.
What about Karen? Do you really think it was her?
Oh, it must have been. She was the only one that knew.
Well, that's not entirely true. I mean, we all knew.
Are you suggesting the staff cannot be trusted?
Well, no, not exactly.
Oh, come off it, Meg. Why would any of us leak information like that? All we get out of it is extra work. Just shows what happens when you trust a prisoner.
Vera, would you inform reception that when Karen arrives, she is to be brought to my office?
I really thought she'd be all right. In the recreation room last night, B was making threats.
Well, what did you do about it?
Well, what could I do? I kept an eye on things, and when B put a foot out of line, I jumped on her.
I'm sorry.
She said she'd see Karen later, but I didn't think she was going to put her under any pressure.
Well, Karen knew the situation. She stood up to B. Smith before.
I know, that's what I mean.
B's too clever to use physical violence. She knows we're watching. I can only conclude that Karen gave the information willingly.
The point is, they'll really crack down on security. Bring Jim Fletcher into the firing line.
Well, we all know about him, don't we?
Still won't be easy.
do we, you know?
For what she did, she deserves it. Slow and painful.
I could poison her.
Oh, don't be stupid, Lizzie.
Why?
Well, for one thing, when you're the cook, it's a bit different. When those shearers got sick, they just blamed your lousy cooking. But if she gets sick, they'll know who did it. And guess who'll get lumbered?
What are we going to do then, B?
I don't know. What about the Big M? Maybe she's got some ideas. What do you reckon, Martha? Maybe you could roll on her and crush her to death. All right, you two, get back at it.
Well, B?
I don't know. Just think about it. Get back to work, you two.
Come in.
You wanted to see me?
I did. Karen, I must confess, I am bitterly disappointed.
Why?
You are well aware of the reason.
I'm sorry, I'm not.
Don't play games, Bella Albrecht.
What about her? You don't mean that I...
Don't pretend, Karen. You are the obvious source.
I haven't said anything.
You and B. Smith discussed the matter last night in the recreation room.
B. asked me about it, but I didn't say anything. Mrs. Jackson was there.
Mrs. Jackson has already reported to me. Now, I realize it is unfortunate that you share a cell with B. Smith, but you are one of the few prisoners who can stand up to her. So why did you tell her? You certainly show no signs of having been coerced.
I haven't been coerced, and I haven't said anything.
Karen, stop lying. How stupid do you think I am? Now, it has been a very trying day, and I do not wish to pursue this matter any further. You will lose your study release, and your parole will be reviewed.
I may have been the obvious source, but I didn't do it.
I had very high hopes for you, Karen, but we learn from our mistakes, and I shall certainly learn from this one. Do you have anything more to say? Anything in mitigation? Then you might think about your responsibility if anything happens to Bella. You will certainly have done your part. Take her away.
Oh, Greg, nothing.
Come on, we're still friends, aren't we?
Are we?
What's the matter? You can't blame me for something I don't even know about.
Why not? I just was. The women know about Bella Albrecht and I'm being blamed.
Oh, good grief. And of course you didn't.
No, I didn't.
Yeah, all right, all right. Keep you cool.
My uni's been suspended and they're reviewing my parole.
Oh, that's ridiculous.
That's what the governor said and she means it.
Well, you can find out who talked. B would know.
B and I aren't on very good terms at the moment. Oh, forget it, Greg. That's just the way things go.
Yeah, well, something will work out.
You know, I was thinking just now, what if something does happen to Bella? The same thing should happen to me.
What are you talking about, Karen?
Well, the women are going to be out to get her because she murdered a child. But she and I did the same thing, Greg. Killed a child for the sake of a man.
Oh, Karen, that's ridiculous.
Why is it ridiculous?
Well, it's a very different thing. I mean, to abort a fetus in the early stages of development, well, that's rather different to killing a five-year-old child in cold blood.
Is it?
Yes, it is.
End of work.
Karen?
Oh.
Maybe you're right.
I knew we were crowded. Surgery in the corridor now, eh, Doc?
I don't care where it is as long as he's here.
Well?
Oh, Greg, I don't know. I don't know. At the moment, I'm just... very confused.
And trust me, as a doctor.
Thanks. I'd better go.
Sure. Karen. Take care.
Right. 500 it is. Come on, Lizzie.
I don't want to play cards.
Sit down. Oh. Okay, that's Lizzie and Monnie and me, and we need a fourth. Come on, Angie. Play cards. Sorry, Martha. All full up.
Okay, that's Lizzie and Monty against Angie and me, and if you cheat, Lizzie, I'll bloody kill you.
Does that mean I'm not supposed to win?
Of course you've got tickets on herself. Well, here comes the traitor in our midst. What's it feel like to be on the other side?
I'm not on anyone's side. I was asked to keep a confidence, and I did.
Yeah, well, as it turned out, we didn't need your help anyway, did we?
No, you didn't, did you? And I hope you're satisfied.
What's that supposed to mean?
Thanks to you, I've lost my parole and my studies have been suspended.
Bean!
Geez, that's a bit heavy. Well, what are you looking at me for?
That's pretty bloody obvious, isn't it?
Well, that... That wasn't supposed to happen.
Oh, I reckon that's terrible.
Shut up, Lizzie. I said that wasn't supposed to happen.
Well, it did.
What can I say? I'm sorry. Oh, yeah, terrific. Fat lot of good that's gonna do. Well, don't worry, I'll go and tell the governor. No skin off my nose.
Who did it?
That idiot from the university.
Peta Clements.
He wouldn't know if he was up to his neck in cow manure. Oh. Don't worry, I'll go and tell the governor right away.
Don't worry, love. I'm sure B'll fix it. He's a bad bugger, isn't he, that Clements?
Yes, he is, Lizzie.
He's the one that sent Doreen around the bend. I'm sure he'll be the next one that B gets a knife into. Oh, getting a knife into it. We're not supposed to talk like that, are we?
Come in. Oh, for heaven's sake, what now? I can't just wait till morning.
No, I don't think you can.
Well?
I thought you might like to know who told me about Bella.
I already know that, Smith.
You don't, you know. It was Doc Clements.
Oh, really, Smith? I spoke to Dr. Clements only this morning. Do you expect me to believe he went straight off and confided in you?
Yeah, stupid, isn't he? I told him I already knew and he couldn't wait to fill in the details. Bloody show-off.
It won't work. Travers and you are cellmates. It's obviously a cover-up.
Mrs. Davidson...
Yes?
In fairness to Karen, don't you think Dr. Clements should at least be questioned?
Right, fair go.
Stay out of this, Smith. Very well. I shall speak to him in the morning. But I assure you it will require something far more substantial than an accusation from you to convince me. Just a moment.
Oh, I'm sorry. I thought we had that sorted out.
You think you're top dog here, right, Smith?
Well, you'd know, Mrs. Davidson.
You have enjoyed that position for quite some time, the advantages of it. I think you should be aware of the disadvantages as well. If anything happens to Bella Albrecht, you will be held responsible.
Can I ask you a question? Seeing as I'm already in here for life and then some, what are you going to do to me if Bella does have an unfortunate accident?
I shall keep you in solitary for as long as I can. Following that, you will be transferred to another prison, somewhere bigger and much tougher.
You can't do that.
Try me. Get her out of here.
Noise. Look, I've been locked up for hours.
If you don't stop making trouble, I'll have you straight back in solitary.
I'm not making trouble. I just want to get out.
Okay.
Is this some kind of setup?
Oh, you're a brave one, aren't you?
Well, how come you've changed your mind?
I haven't changed my mind. I was coming to get you anyway. You've got to have your shower now, so get your things. Don't worry, you'll be locked back in straight away afterwards.
Why can't I have my shower when everybody else does?
It's for your own protection. Why we bother protecting the likes of you, I'll never know. Come on. This way.
Have they been saying anything about me?
Who?
The prisoners.
They don't have me in their confidence. Come on.
Ah, reception.
Pleasant memories. Through there. Now get a move on.